What up?
What up? What up?
I think this is episode 15.
16,
15, one of them. We'll get it right in the title. We got a special, special, special show today. It is so inspirational.
Yes.
Right? You was coming up with a title because we're doing this on the fly. What's the title?
Food for Your Spirit.
Food for Your Spirit on a Sunday evening, a week before football season.
A Sunday afternoon.
A Sunday afternoon. You know, I was thinking about this. I don't know if you were thinking about it like this, but man, I love hip hop, man.
Yeah. You love hip hop.
You do too.
I mean, not like you do, though.
All I gotta do is put that, let me see, put on something like, look at them girl with them Daisy Dukes on. You can't even be still.
Anyway, go ahead.
Anyway, so I love hip hop. I love what hip hop does. I love everything about it. But I have to acknowledge some things before hip hop. I don't like to say R&B. I like to say soul music.
Okay.
And gospel music.
Okay.
Gospel music, you know. And when we were thinking about doing this podcast, I'm brainstorming. I'm sitting out in the garage. I'm like, man, you know, what songs can I listen to that no matter what's going on, they get me going?
And when you say get you going, what you mean by that?
The lyrics are inspirational. The lyrics are things that make you want to push. It just feels good. No matter what's going on.
Calm you down.
Yeah.
Get you hype.
Get you hype. It's not just that for me.
Motivate you.
That's you. It's not just that for me. I want to add something else to it. It's also when you're afraid.
Yeah.
When you in fear, like, I mean, let's keep it real. Every time that I've interviewed for a job, I go through that thing in my mind. Like, yo, you could do this.
Right.
I'm not trying to hear. Now, what you hear is not a test. I ain't trying to hear that.
Right.
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 So, you know, gospel music does that for me.
Right.
But with me, the difference between me and you, let's separate this right here. You have extensive experience in singing in a choir.
Yes.
I do not.
I am a choir singer.
So.
Not anymore. I used to sing in the choir.
When I listen to music and stuff like that, I'm listening for individual words and messages over a melodic, let's say, a great melody, right?
I mean, I listen to the messages and the words too.
I know you do.
I mean, it ministers to my spirit. It speaks to me.
Speaks to my spirit. I think we got something on deck that talks about that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so this episode is, you know, we wanted to dig in and say, hey, these are things outside of what you might hear us doing in the secular life.
Right.
That we have roots
right
in.
It's our foundation.
Right, it's our foundation.
Right.
Gospel music, we don't have to do no history and stuff.
Because everybody gospel
ancestors
music.
And singing right, in the fields. Right. You can't, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say, being a black person, you might not be in church every Sunday.
Right.
And you might not be riding around in your car playing gospel.
Mm-hmm.
But every now and then, one slips through.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, whoa, you got to pay attention.
Right.
Even if you are the biggest sinner on
right,
the planet.
Right.
It slips through. A couple of years ago, it was, well, X amount of years ago, it was Marvin Sapp.
Marvin Sapp. Never would have made it.
Mm-hmm. Did you know anybody that didn't like that song?
Everybody played that
Everybody
song.
Everybody loved that song.
I think it was even on the secular radio
it
stations.
It was in the, they call it R&B now.
Right.
It was in the R&B charts.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, he probably has songs that are big, but nothing as big as that.
I got
one that we're going to play today that I think is close to being that big.
Okay.
But when we play it, we get to it. So, any shout outs, anything like that before we get into this?
I mean, shout out to everybody, to all of our listeners.
Everybody.
All of our current listeners and hopefully our future listeners. We get some, you know, some more followers and stuff.
And for the future listeners, where can they find us?
Oh my goodness. You always do this to me. So,
yay, yay.
8121talk.com.
Yep.
Google Podcasts.
Google Podcasts.
Apple Podcasts.
Apple Podcasts.
Spotify.
Spotify.
YouTube.
YouTube.
Anchor.
Anchor.
That's it, right?
You got it.
Oh, shoot. I got it.
So we got all those outlets mm-hmm. to hear us. And we need to say exactly who we are.
It's Alan Elondious. Got to be more careful.
And we are off. Episode
16.
16. I think it's 15, but episode.
No, it's 16.
Episode 16.
Yes.
Ladies first, I give you the pleasure. We both have roots in this song.
Yes.
And while this song is playing, we will be talking a little bit. So don't nobody like get like, oh, they should let the song play. We can't do that because YouTube will kill us.
Right. That's the main reason why we stopped doing music.
Right.
And we've had several people comment and say, hey, I liked it when y'all used to do the music. Yeah, I kind of missed that and everything. Easy. But we're going to try to get back to it.
We try to get back to it.
We might not do it every episode, but there will be some music.
Right.
Coming.
Right.
Something.
Right.
Because I missed the music too. But.
Let's set it up.
Okay.
Your first choice.
My first choice.
Is a classic.
Yes, it is.
It's a classic. It's from the 70s.
I think everybody our age know this song.
Now, what I'm interested in is the choir aspect of it.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I hear this song, I think that if you're going to have a song, I'm in a choir, you have to do this song. You have to.
Okay. Okay.
It, for me, it's got all the elements in it.
Okay.
So I'm gonna start playing this, and I want you to tell me where it takes you.
Okay.
When you hear it. You ready?
Mm-hmm. Let's go. In.
This is Walter Hawkins.
With his sister singing.
Tremaine Hawkins.
Tremaine.
I thought that was his wife.
I thought Tremaine. Let me be quiet then.
Going up to Yonder. Classic.
Going Up to Yonder is the first song that me and my cousins and whatever used to sing when we played church in the backyard.
Okay.
At my great-grandma's house or wherever we was at, down on the chute in Lancaster, Kentucky.
Right.
We'll be out there singing. And I think my cousin Don was always the choir director. So he would have us all lined up singing this song, and he'd be leading us and everything. And I can remember my grandma coming out on the back porch, or my great-grandma, talking about, y'all better stop playing with the Lord. Somebody gonna catch the spirit for real out here.
Right.
Then you gonna find out.
Right.
So it's one of the first songs I learned how to sing. And it's just a inspirational song.
Love Alive, I think it was 1975, was the first album that I really studied.
Okay.
And all these songs on there, but this was the biggest one.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And it was like, whoa, like, what is this? Her singing is...
Right.
It, like, pierces you.
Mm-hmm.
And then the band...
Mm-hmm.
...is incredible.
The musicians.
The swing on it.
Yeah.
Let's
the words too, you know. Just listen to it.
Let's feel it like that.
Okay.
Don't that song make you feel some type of way.
Yeah, it makes you feel good.
Make you feel some type of way. Mm-hmm. Tremaine Hawkins, Walter Hawkins. I don't know much about the gospel genre and who's considered stars and legends. I'm sure he has to be.
Oh, you know it, yeah.
He has to
be. Yeah. He's one of the greats.
Wow. Ironically, my first song that I'm going to choose comes from the same album.
Okay.
I don't know if you were playing this prior, but I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with me, this song is called Change.
Right.
And every time I not just for me, but the song is called Change. And for me, it's like in all my moments of drinking, hanging out, like my grandmother used to say, Debmit.
Debmit.
Every time I heard this song, it always made me think, you can change. You can change. So, yeah, I don't want to sound
this is one of the choir songs that we've sung before.
You have sung this?
Yeah.
Incredible song.
I think Michelle and Terry sung this song, led this song.
I don't know who Michelle and Terry is, but...
Yeah, choir members from Faith Gospel.
I can literally see
your mama singing this song.
Well, my living room on First Avenue, I could see it because I wasn't allowed to pick the needle up, so I would have to, you know, just I let every song play. And sometimes you'll find something you like by letting it play.
Right, right.
We just gonna get to the chorus right here, right? How it's in a certain groove, you know, and it's not coming at you, but eventually,
right,
it picks up and it's like, wow,
it you know hits what I mean? You.
Y'all play this one?
Did we play it at home?
Yeah. This one was, I mean, it's, for me, it's powerful. I mean, that's what the show is about.
Right.
You know, songs that strike us.
Yeah, this so one. Y'all might need to get some tissue. I don't know.
I'm fighting. Well,
just get ready to feel good. Just get ready to feel good.
Yeah. You there yet? You ready for more songs?
So what's good about this song is it definitely lets you know that it's not too late. It's not too late to change. It's not too late. It's not too late.
Now
you just have to be ready.
I'm gonna do something unorthodox here.
Okay.
Because if I was on a set and I'm doing a party, usually right here, I got to go, God, what the? Hey, stop it. Just go back.
Right, right, right.
What's next?
Okay,
we got to hit them with something.
So, okay. So,
can I surprise you?
Oh, okay, you're going to do, okay, I had something, but go ahead, surprise me.
You had something? Tell me.
Go on, surprise me, because I see you in it right now.
Let me set it up. So,
okay.
You can't make it to church.
You can't make it to church.
You out there by yourself. Mm-hmm, you in the field by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
There's no one around you that's telling you the things that you need to hear.
Okay. Okay.
What do you need to do? I'll start the song.
Encourage yourself.
Who's this by?
Donna Lawrence and the Tri-City Singers. Sometimes you gotta do it yourself. Can't depend on other people to encourage you. Speak the word. Speak over yourself. Encourage yourself. You gotta pat your own self on the back.
All right. I see you over there busted at the seams.
You know, I did a praise dance to this.
Okay, I was saving that, but
so,
okay.
Yeah.
Do you see your praise dance?
I can see it in my head.
Let me see.
And that verse right there, depression is all around, but God's a present help. You got to tell yourself this. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because you know I suffer from depression, but you got to talk to yourself to bring yourself out of that depression. I'm trying to tell you. I minister to myself. Life can hurt you so. Till you feel there's nothing left. No matter how you feel. Speak the word over your life. And you will be healed. And tell yourself you can make it. The power of your own tongue.
Even if nobody tell you, you can run on you.
You tell yourself.
You gotta remember, I'm more than a conqueror.
I am
the man. Greater is he that's in me.
Greater is he.
Everything the enemy ever told me.
It's a lie. It's a lie. I'm encouraged. I'm encouraged.
All right.
Are you encouraged? I'm encouraged.
I'm getting cool. Not the cool I came about.
I'm encouraged. Come on now.
See, I never really listened to this all the way through.
Right.
So, just in case, let me stop. Mm-hmm. Just in case someone said, I thought you were saying but a lot of these songs I didn't. I don't listen to them.
Right.
I don't listen to them, especially this one.
Okay.
I'm
gonna run out. Keep running and see what the end is gonna be.
Let me find out you up on that pool thing. That's what you're doing?
Nah.
That was getting a little tense.
I might still be running from that, but go on now.
I'm looking over the table, right? Mm-hmm. And I don't know what you're doing over there, but I might need to turn the lights up a little bit so I don't lose you.
Oh, come on now.
Hey, before you jump up and shout my like,
hey.
Babe,
really?
I got out of control. But I don't catch the spirit because it's dark in here and I'm spooky.
Oh, my goodness. Boy, go on with your song.
Oh, man. I don't know what to do now. You just, I don't have a song. Like,
see, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, man.
The music takes you. It just, like I said, the food music. For the spirit. Food for the spirit.
Let's go.
Makes you feel good in your spirit.
I'm going back to Walter.
Okay, come on, Walter.
I'm going back to Walter. This
Why?
One does it.
Why this song?
It's what they're saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the title is I Won't Be Satisfied.
Yep.
Like, you're going to keep doing what you're doing, but you won't be satisfied until you back with Jesus,
yep.
So to speak.
Yeah.
Sometimes I feel discouraged. A little bit. This song makes me drive fast.
It makes you what?
Drive fast.
Drive fast. You can't take it.
I gotta stop it. I gotta stop it because
I'm telling them to get some tissue. We might have should have brought some tissue in here with us.
That song.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm on the highway, easy, honey.
Mm-hmm.
Easy.
I know you get lost, don't you?
You get lost.
And that's when you be saying, Jesus, take the wheel, because I ain't got it no more.
I don't talk like that, but somebody get it. Somebody get it. Let's go.
Jesus got it.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah, it'll take you there.
I won't be satisfied. Walter Hawkins, still 1975. I ain't even get to nothing modern yet. Mm-mm. I'm still hanging around in the 70s. Does that make me a weirdo?
No.
Okay. Now, since I got the tables, I got the set.
Okay.
I get to choose, okay. And you get to react.
Okay.
I had a hard time getting this song.
Mm-hmm.
You already know what it is, don't you?
Yep.
I had a hard time getting it, but I noticed that when I play it, somebody gets a little excited.
Mm-hmm.
Give me the name of the song and the singer.
I Will Bless the Lord. Oh, yeah. Byron Cage.
Come on, do the second one. For the Lord our God is great.
For the Lord our God is great.
Come on, okay. Say, perfect Lord in all your way.
Perfect Lord in all your way.
I like to say this. God of mercy, Lord.
God of mercy, Lord of grace.
Come on, sing it to me tonight.
Let me tell you about this song. So when I deployed to Iraq at Cobb Spiker back in 08-09, I think that's when we was deployed, yeah, 08-09. Of course we have church services in the desert and everything, and we had a praise dance ministry. And Master Sergeant retired Dawson. I'm not sure if he retired as a Master Sergeant or if he made Sergeant Major. But he was over the praise dance ministry, and he's all hype. I don't think I ever seen Eric down. He's always hype, full of energy, always got a smile on his face and everything. And this song is the perfect song for him. And we did a praise dance off of this. It was like a mime praise dance and everything. You're talking about somebody was tired when we got finished dancing to this song, because it is long, but I mean, all times. I would bless the Lord at all times. That's all I can say. I would bless the Lord at all times. When you're feeling down, start blessing the Lord. Start praising the Lord. And I promise you, you won't be feeling down no more.
What year is this song? I'll be in the 90s.
I don't know what year the song came out, but I just know it's just one of them songs that you be like, if you listen to the words to the song,
I will bless the Lord by Byron Cage.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. I will bless the Lord at all times. Been right there. Through thick and through thin. He changed my talk. Do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
Can't nobody.
Can't nobody.
Do me like the Lord can.
Love me like the Lord can.
I will bless the Lord.
He brought me out.
I will bless the Lord.
To take me in.
I will bless the Lord.
He knows what's best for me.
I will bless the Lord. He brought me out to take me in. He brought me out of darkness to take me into the marvelous light. He brought me out of poverty to take me into richness. Only because of God's grace.
That once was an empty plane. He has done great
things for me. He has done great things for me. So I will.
He has done great things for me. So I will.
I will bless the Lord.
Yeah, kind of.
At all times.
I thought you was about to break out the sermon in a minute.
Oh, come on now! Don't get me started up in here.
Man, yeah, that song is dope. It's another one where the groove,
mm-hmm,
and the call and response. It's, mm-hmm, not really a call and response. It's the choir kind of like finishing off,
mm-hmm,
what he's saying. But great song.
Mm-hmm.
Great song.
You know, it always gets me hyped.
I see. Now, so my first songs were old because they remind me of my childhood. These are things I connect with and the message and the feeling. But then as of lately, there are songs where the message, you got to be an alien to not identify with what they're saying.
Yeah.
Now, you introduced me to a young lady. From what I understood.
Come on, like her, this powerhouse right
her,
here.
Her life might not be all that perfect, but she definitely has a gift.
Yes.
She murders. Is that a good word to say? She kills the songs.
She has a gift. I don't even know what to say.
You know, I was in shock about, I was looking at some show or something, and judgmental. They were kind of judgmental of her. You know, I didn't understand that. I didn't think that should have been a topic on that show. But she delivers.
Yeah, she does.
She delivers. You ready?
Come on now. Come on.
Let's get it.
Help you get over your past.
And this is Donna Lawrence speaking.
Donna Lawrence. Leandria.
Johnson.
Leandria.
I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Deliver me, 'cause all I seem to do is hurt me. Hurt me, yeah. Lord, deliver me, 'cause all I see to do is hurt me.
Yes, sir. Sing it for me two more times.
About you, but whenever I hear this song, it just really speaks to me. It speaks to me because a lot of us would say it's people. Oh, people did this to me. This person did that, and this person did that. But most of the time, it's your own self that is hurting you. You know, we can't get out of our own way sometimes, and the situations that we find ourselves in, the relationships that we find ourselves in, is because we're hurting ourselves. It's not somebody else hurting us. It's ourselves. I'm hurting me. And sometimes you just have to cry out to God and tell him, you know, ask him, man, Lord, deliver me, because all I seem to do is hurt me. It's not no one else hurting me. It's me hurting me. Come on, Leandria.
It is so.
Woo.
Yeah, that's
okay,
a big one.
So now
that's
you got me over here in tears and everything.
But we're not done. We're
my
not
eyes
done.
Burning.
We're not done. So, a few months ago, I saw a video of a guy. I'm trying to get you set over there so you can,
okay.
You can get your shoulders ready.
I'm trying.
Because I'm coming with him. I saw a video of a guy sitting in front of a piano. I never heard of him before.
Right.
And he was singing about food. Heavy guy with a beard. And I said, wow, his voice is powerful. And then you told me, oh, that's John P. Key.
John P. Key.
Right. So.
Ooh, before we go into this song.
Yeah.
Let me give you some background on this song.
Okay.
So,
What song is it?
I say the whole thing every time I turn around. God's making the way.
Good enough.
You know, and a lot of other people know that my oldest daughter's father died when I was
Lucius, right?
5 months pregnant with her, and before then, I was always in church. Man, I've been going to church since a little child, but always going to church since I was about 10 or 11.
Right.
Up until that time. And once he died and I'm pregnant, I'm 19, don't know what the world I'm going to do. I was mad at God.
Okay.
Just totally mad. And so I stayed out of church from 1987. And I did not go back to church till 1997.
Right.
97, because we was at Fort Gordon.
Fort Gordon.
And my next door neighbor, Judith, First Lady Augustine.
Judith, hell of a name.
Yeah, we call her T. Judy.
Okay.
So she said, come on, go to church with me. Come go to church with me. And mm-hmm. I was like, I don't know if I want to go to church. But I went to church with her on post at Fort Gordon, Faith Gospel Community Chapel. We had church in the theater on Fort Gordon. And I sat in the very last row on the end, close to the door, so that I could get up and go if I felt like I needed to. And the choir sung this song. Every time I turned around, they sung this song. And I realized then that even though I was mad at God, God had to be mad at me. And every time I turned around, he always made a way for me. Even when I didn't realize he was making a way, he was making a way. So this is the song, thanks to T. Judy, that opened my eyes and opened my heart and brought me back to the church. So come on, play it. Doors that I could not see.
For me.
You know, I almost did that. For who?
Right.
I almost did it, but I'm holding back over here. All right, let's go.
Come on.
No, let's get that verse clear. Let's get that verse clear. Let's do it right. When I was down to my very last time, you did it.
Turn around. Man, I can see now First Lady Beverly directing the choir, Connie. She was throwing the watch off and everything. I'm telling you.
Now listen, I can't testify for you, and you can't testify for me. So I'm going to ask you a question.
Man, my Faith Gospel family, come on, Faith Gospel.
Now, My next song.
Come on.
How do I say this? I listen to this with a secular ear.
Mm-hmm.
Because a beautiful song is just that. It's just a beautiful song.
Right.
And the way I look at it, everybody needs help.
Everybody
needs help. And then you sometimes you don't even realize that people are helping you.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other side of that help, it's how do you repay them for helping you?
Right.
Right. So every time I hear this song, you know what I think about?
Mm-mm.
You.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah. I'm in Colorado Springs because of you. I mean, I was in a situation where I was like, I've told you this. I felt like if I would have, wasted away.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So that's all I'm going to say.
Okay. Yeah. Don't have me crying over here again. So
this song, I listened to it with a secular ear, but, you know, plus I think the guy's voice is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
I have so many friends that are no longer here. Why he took them away and left me here, I'm not clear.
Featuring PJ Morton.
Yeah, I didn't choose any teachers.
I guess I have more to do, and he has more assignments for me to complete. I still can't believe that you want to use me. I often fall down, and I'm so imperfect, but you still love me when I feel I'm not worth it. Oh, it could have been me, dead and gone, but you never left me all alone, and I'll never be able to repay you for all you've done.
I listen to it with a secular ear like that. Like, it's like, yo, okay. Sometimes you just gotta, you know, you gotta, it is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, sometimes you need help.
Yeah, yeah.
And a lot of people don't be knowing they need help, right? And I'm not even talking from a gospel perspective. I'm just saying
From life in general.
Like, and yeah. I don't know about this next song. I know about it.
Okay.
This is your last one.
Okay.
But I know about it, meaning I've heard it before.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know how it's going to affect you. I'm a little nervous over here. I'm just a little nervous. So are you ready?
I'm ready. Come on.
Let's get it. Talk to me about this song.
So, of course, this is another choir song that I've done, but the song, period. Just listen to the words. No matter what, when you're sitting around feeling down for yourself, like when I retired from the Army, I didn't think that I was where I should have been. But then I had to remind myself that I had to get ready for my blessing, because God's got a blessing with my name on it, and he's still in the miracle working business. So whenever, like with this podcast, we don't get the followers and the likes and stuff that we want and everything, but God's got a blessing with our name on it. And it's coming.
What'd you say?
It's coming.
Podcast what?
I said with this podcast, we don't always get the likes and we don't have the followers, you know, whatever, where we think we should be, but God's got a blessing with our name on it. He's going to bless it. And it's going to come. So we're going to get ready for our miracle.
Let me encourage you. It's gonna well be all right. Troubles and trials come to make you strong. Keep on believing. You keep holding on. Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing. Say that with me. God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
If you really believe it, God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Come on. God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on. God's got a blessing.
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 With your name on it.
With your name on it.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
I knew that song would pull you out. I knew it was. We got one more.
One more.
One more song before we get out of here.
Right, because I don't know if I can take it anymore. Come on.
Well, this one is mine.
Yes.
Well, I know, because I know you got some praise dancing that goes on with
this. Yep, yep.
And with me, when I first started listening to this song, I was like, wow. You know, you ever been in a situation where you try everything to alter, proceed, whatever you're fighting. But this song, guess what it tells you to do? Guess.
Stand.
Just stand. Just stand and let things be.
Donnie McClurkin. And we forgot to say, God's got a blessing. Norman Hutchins.
Norman Hutchins. Right. Mm-hmm. Sorry about that. That's a real one for her.
Right.
That's a real one. Yeah, but Donnie McClurkin, stand. Sometimes, you know.
That's all you can do.
Yeah. And I told you, especially when I was in Harlem, I couldn't wait for the lights to go out and the TVs were off, because everything that was troubling me, you ever had things that are troubling you and you don't know what to do?
Yes.
It's like you're thinking,
plenty of times,
overthinking this, that. Sometimes you just gotta,
you just gotta stand. Come on now.
I know we're about to get some praise dance moving over there. So if y'all hit a mic, going like that, that's what it is.
When you've done all you can and it seems like it's never enough, and what do you say when your friends turn away and you're all alone, all alone? Tell me, what do you give when you're giving your seems like you can't make it through.
when there's nothing left to do, you just stand and watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand.
How could this song not move you?
I know, right?
Tell me, how do you handle
the shame,
guilt of your past? Tell me, how do you deal with the shame?
How do you deal with the shame?
And how can you smile while your heart has been broken and filled with pain? Your
own. I don't know what just happened, but we leave it.
Seems like when you're giving your all,
make it through. Child, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand once the Lord sees you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just
stand
and be sure, you're not entangled in that bondage again. You just
stand
and be sure, God has a purpose. Yes, God has a plan. Tell me,
what do you do?
It's Alan Elondious. Got to be more careful.